warm welcome from London. We are Truxy Theatre at UC MMA 35 in association with GPG, Global Proving Grounds. What are we expecting to see tonight?
Well, Sylvie, my name is Neil Goliath Grove, and I'm one of the fighters in Warrior Island. Voted on, thank you guys. We're going to expect a stacked card with some amazing fights. We have middleweight title fight between Karlos Vemola and the reigning champion, Denniston Sutherland. And then there's a couple of guys starting their debut fights, so all exciting stuff.
Well, I'll be keeping a close eye on the contenders tonight, obviously hoping that some of them are going to get voted to be on the island, because I will be responsible for getting them in shape and polishing them up. So it will be a very interesting event for me to watch and experience.
Yeah, I just heard that you're one of the coaches and one of the strength and conditioning coaches, and I'm looking forward to it. I've seen some of your movies. You're an exciting fighter, world champion as well. So yeah, many years ago, it doesn't matter. You still look in great shape. So looking forward to it.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. It's main event time. Let's meet the fighters.
I'm Karlos Vemola, fighting out of London Shoot Fighters, representing Elite MMA.
Denniston Sutherland, I'm from Harrow, fighting out of Hemel Martial Arts.
I've been training really hard for this fight. I'm fighting the champion. He was a champion while I was away for a little while. Now it's my time to come and get a belt.
My training's gone well, as usual. I've trained everything, worked on every area of my game. fighting Karlos, so you know, I gotta be ready.
Denniston, you are a champion tonight. As I said, you're the champion because I was away for a little while. Now I'm coming to collect my title.
Karlos, I hear you want to clean up the division. You want to beat every middleweight champ. You got to start with me. Let's see how well you do.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been UC MMA 35 in association with Global Proving Ground. And now this is your main event. This is a UC MMA title in the middleweight division, mixed martial arts, 3 5 in a rounds. Denniston Sutherland versus Karlos Vemola. We have Karlos Vemola just making his way down to the cage now. Neil, your thoughts?
Expect an explosive start from this man. You know, we all know how he starts his fights. He dashes in, goes for the takedown, slam, and ground and pound. But he's got a very worthy opponent in Denniston Sutherland, being the champion.
Sutherland has a very active career, 30 fights, 20 wins, 10 losses. It's definitely not his first time in the cage.
No, not at all. You know, when he's one of us, 40 years old and older, fighting, still fighting, and he also started late in his fight, you know, he's at age in his fighting career. He was almost 34 when he started fighting. I was 36. And but he's had a very, very active career. You know, he's been busy. He loves fighting. There's no ring rust with him. Whereas Karlos Vemola, coming from a major big event, probably had 4 fights in 2 years, and Denniston has had 4 fights in like 3 months.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is sponsored by Iron Gym, also sponsored by officialwatches.com and sanctioned by Safe MMA, and is our main event of the evening. Are you ready? I said, are you ready? It's go time! 3 rounds of fighting for the UC MMA Middleweight Championship. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist with a record of 9 wins, 4 losses. With all 9 wins coming by early stoppage. He stands 6 feet tall. He weighed 84 kilograms. Fighting out 11 Shoot Fighters. Your challenger, here is Karlos the Terminator Vemola. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist with a record of 20 wins, 10 losses. With 10 wins coming by way of knockout. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall. He weighed 84 kilograms. Fighting out of Hemel Martial Arts, make some noise for your current reigning, defending, ultimate challenge middleweight champion, Denniston Mad Max Sutherland.
Mm-hmm. go, guys. 3-5s, championship fight. Any questions? Protect yourselves at all times. Listen to my word of command at all times. If I say stop, you stop. Touch gloves, get ready for war.
Last show of respect there from two fighters. I like Sutherland's discomposure. He looks relaxed. He looks like he's just eaten a big pie. He's ready to go for a nap. Vemola, in contrast, looks particularly primed. You called him, Mr. Grove. Out of the shoe fighters, Vemola comes straight out with the parachute double leg.
Every shoe fighter has done this tonight. Straight in for the takedown, slam. And now it's all about that ground control. You know, he's got the wrestling background. He's going to have all that training from the shoot fighters. And now it's all about Denniston Sutherland showing his resilience, showing how tough he is and what he's learned in his 30 fights, this being his 31st fight in MMA.
We're going to see how tricky he is with his guard. At the moment, Vemola. Oh, nice pass there into half guard. Sutherland was just defending the shots, being tricky with his open guard, but he let Vemola pass with that hammer fist. Sutherland looking to bury that underhook. Vemola looks like the stronger of the two.
Yeah, being that muscular sometimes does count against you. You've got to use it, especially in the beginning stages of the fight. Otherwise, those muscles take up all the gas.
One of the important things for these fighters who are in this kind of condition is to remember to breathe. I once read a quote from Barnett, who said when he was putting on a heel hook over in Pride, that he forgot to breathe when he's applying it. The guy nearly got out of it. He couldn't work out why the guy wasn't tapping. Then he realized he wasn't breathing.
Yeah, I think the term breathe really literally means you need to relax and not get too anxious.
This is going pretty much by the book so far for Vemola. Nice pass there. It's a side. Using a hand of God. That's an interesting strike he's throwing there. He passed over his head and then he's throwing the punch literally round his own thigh towards his butt to his opponent.
Yeah, London shoot fighters cover every aspect of the game.
Every single angle has been looked into.
Now he slipped over his arm there. It's going to stop him from protecting himself.
Is he going to go into the Ivan Salivary position? Expose him with the open crucifix? Or is he looking for the... No, it looks like he's going for the... I think that's a Kimura. Yep. Not quite the Americana. Again, the story of the evening. London shoot fighter takes a guy down, passes his side control, looks for a Kimura. Puts himself back into half guard there.
He's just showing off his control. He's got great ground control. His wrestling is immense. You can see, obviously, softening up Denniston Sutherland. I think Denniston wanted this fight to be upstanding a little bit longer.
This is a fantastic fight for global proving ground. From UC MMA, folks, your main event. I'd like to thank some of our sponsors tonight, bodybuilding.com, Power Productions, Herbal Life
by Neil Goliath Grove.
Check out the website, folks. Yeah. Neil Goliath Grove.
MMA.com.
Surfeit Mouth Guards. Warrior Island TV series coming at you soon. Sutherland is still in this fight. He's running those underhooks.
In full guard now.
Now notice the way of Vemola. He squares his hips up to Sutherland. So when Sutherland's anchoring out to either left or right, trying to cut an angle and create either a sweep position, he's squaring up the hips there, taking away the position. Step over pass now for Vemola. Oh, looking for that half, that side choke, sorry. Sutherland sees it.
Great display of ground control here by Karlos Vemola.
It's particularly impressive. The younger fighters can learn a lot by watching this kind of performance. He's controlling his opponent, he's being active and aggressive, he's landing strikes, but he's constantly advancing position. Looks like he puts himself in half guard again there.
It's all about control, you know. These guys fight not just... Well, let me just put it this way. They fight for one reason and one reason only, and that's to win. And whatever it takes. He knows that Denniston Sutherland is a really tough character, and he's obviously got him on the ground trying to soften him up
for the next round.
And we have come to the end of round one, folks. Mr. Grove, who would you give that round to?
That's an overwhelming win there by Karlos Vemola. You know, from the takedown, from the word go, he was a control.
Batteries Plus bulbs keep stacks of batteries for cars, cell phones, watches, plus light bulbs for lamps, can lights, and appliances right on hand. Did I mention we also repair smartphones? Batteries Plus bulbs. Trust the plus. Visit Batteries Plus bulbs today.
The win. Okay, what would you like to see from Sutherland now to change the shape of this fight?
Keep it upstanding. Make sure that Karlos does not take you down.
Karlos just powering that high crutch single. There was a degree of technique there, but he was the stronger man in that position.
Yeah, you can see from his legs, and that's where all the power came from, picking his opponent up, all about legs.
He landed in the same spot that he landed in the first round as well.
Well, unfortunately for Denniston, he's right in front of his corner, so right now he'll get the best possible advice on how to neutralize Karlos Vemola's attack.
This is perfect position, though, for Vemola. He's got his shoulders just on the base of the cage and his head caught up against the fencing itself. It takes away a lot of the movement and a lot of the options for Sutherland. Big, heavy right-hands there. Sutherland looks like he's anchoring for an armbar with his arm positioning, but he doesn't have the position with his legs.
No, and although Karlos Vemola is causing all the damage right now, and slowly but surely, as you can see, Denniston Sutherland's eyes are starting to shut up from all the array of punches, you know, falling on his head. He's still in there. He's still tough. You can't count him out until the dying seconds of the last round.
He's a veteran, a very scrappy veteran. He's not been finished so far. A very loose half guard here. Vemola is just running this position. He's just using this to collect up, I wouldn't say points, because he's doing damage. Nice pass. Sutherland looks to use the underhook. Ooh, he nearly uses that to stand up with there. Looking for the elevator sweep. Ditches out. Vemola looking to pass through. Smash pass with the knee.
And to the untrained eye sitting at the on the pavilion there, there's a lot of technique going on here right now, a lot of control and a lot of hard work. This is tiring.
Sutherland is using a lot of butterfly guard here. He's using that to take, well, some of the steam off the ground and pound strikes, but not too much. Nice pass there. And Sutherland reclaims half guard. Looking for the sweep, very loose. Excellent base there by Vemola. Attempt at a jumping pass. Sutherland got the underhook. Yes, he does. Will he turn into it? No, he does not. Cycle pass there by Vemola. He's got his hips down. He's going to spread Sutherland out now.
This is a grappling exhibition firm here by Karlos Vemola. Mm.
Classic Brazilian jiu-jitsu on show here. Top control. The hand of God now. That right hand is just between the hips. It's stopping Sutherland from coming around and reclaiming a half or a full guard. North-south position. Sutherland, very, very tricky there to reclaim half guard. It's a very loose half guard. It's almost a quarter guard. Well, it is a quarter guard. And Vemola sits back into half guard again. It's interesting how he's trapping Sutherland's head with his own arms while he's stretching out, and he's using that to base him out. Vemola's pretty much doing everything correct. I would like to see him either pass or put him up against the fence and actually do some real damage with some ground and pound from within the guard, Tito Ortiz style.
Yeah, then just as you said it, he's doing it. Needs to posture up a little bit more. Throw in some bombs, try and finish the fight.
This is similar to the fight earlier. Ultimately, he should pass to a full mount and then make the referee stop the fight.
Yeah.
I don't think he's going to get a submission here. Sutherland seems way too cagey. Sutherland looking to use that underhook now. Looking with a rockabye pass, sorry, rockabye sweep. Vemola all over it. Nice wide, heavy base. And we fight our way out of round number two. Sutherland is definitely the slower man to stand there.
What does quality of life mean to you? Focus on what makes you feel good about yourself. Physical and mental strength to conquer challenges. Feeling energy and motivation. All-encompassing optimum health. When you think you have nothing else to give. New Yellow. The all-new GPG Sports Complex has over 25,000 square feet of combat sports training and fitness. We specialize in mixed martial arts, boxing, kickboxing, and self-defense. Train like a fighter or become a fighter. Elite training plus the best live sporting events around. Start your free 1 week of training today by calling 609-923-2663 or stop by 1205 Route 73 in Mount Laurel, New Jersey, or go to MMAGMNJ.com.
Show of respect there from fighters. UCMO 35, Global Proving Ground. This is the last round, folks. Vemola engages in the stand-up just enough to look for that deep high crotch single, dropping down for a low, resetting, ankle pick. Collecting on both knees now. He's going to try and put his hands together. How does Sutherland defend this, Neil?
No, he had the underhooks there, but he let go, and then right now he's in a precarious position, as you can see.
He was looking for that face bar, or the cross face, if you will. And then Navarro used that to switch position and just trip him down. This is the story of the fight. Again, he shoots in, he takes him down, he controls him.
This is one of those George St. Pierre fights, you know. A lot of people call it boring, but at the end of the day, you do what you need to do to keep or win the title. And Carlos Mora is just doing everything by book right now.
The reality is we're possibly looking at two 10-8 rounds.
Still being edged on by his corner.
They're looking for him to finish this fight.
And I'm not hearing anything coming from Denniston's corner. Denniston needs to get this fight upstanding. He needs to land at least one or two really, really big strikes to the head.
Vemola's identifying that looks like Denniston's going to use the underhook and will walk, so he's taking the option away from him here. Strike, 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 strike. How do you see Sutherland standing up from this and changing the shape of this fight?
It's really, really hard. He needs to get his back up against the fence. He's not going to do it from here. Carlos Mola is like an octopus. His arms and his legs are wrapped right round Sutherland. There's no way he can get up. He needs the cage.
Vemola has full pass now. Hand of God, cycling round north-south position. Switching at the hips. I'd like to see Vemola advance now. Advance into mount. Do some damage from here. Sutherland just doing just enough to defend those strikes. Nothing landing properly clean. Nice switch to the opposite side there from Vemola. Sutherland now stands up beautifully. Gave away his back. Vemola didn't quite get the sprawl. Vemola hunting at the double. Sutherland doesn't quite have the strength to peel this away. Vemola dropping down now, looking to collect up both knees. Nice turn from Sutherland. He needs to turn another 180 from there. Nice pick there. Collected up both sides of his hips, switched over the side, bucked and rolled.
For a brief second there, it looked like Denniston got a good knee in, but just, you know, cannot stop the resilience of Carlos Vemola's takedowns. It's never ending. And here comes
the side choke. Oh, what a crafty veteran Sutherland is. He saw that coming. Perfect defense. Get the arm out of there. If it's not in there, you can't be choked with it. He's incredibly tough and resilient. I'm curious as to what's going through Vemola's head now. He must be thinking, what do I have to do to pass this guy's guard and finish him?
I think he's just in automatic mode. Just keep doing what I'm doing, you know. I've got him control on the ground. Just keep working at him. Keep scoring those points.
I wonder if at this point he's willing to just carry on that automatic mode, not look for the finish. He's almost a knee to the face there. Accidental, though. Excellent referee all over that. Mr. Grant Waterman.
This is a great display by Carlos. He needs two or three more of these sort of fights. You can see him back in some really, really big promotions. You cannot take away from him his absolute dominance tonight on the ground against...
He swallowed Sutherland whole.
Yeah.
Sutherland's tough. He's very tough, very cagey. He knows the setups, but he doesn't have the tools to deal with Vemola. He's too athletic, too big, but too accurate with his technique as well. Nice pass there. Looking for that straight armbar from side control position. Sutherland with the underhook. Good strikes here from Vemola. Vemola looking to end the round dramatically. Big dump. Donkey Kong strikes.
Fantastic display there of wrestling skills by Carlos Vemola, and another emphatic win by London Shoot Fighters.
Vemola knows he's won that.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of mixed martial arts action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout, 26-30. Judge number two, 27-30. And judge number three, 27-30. For your winner by unanimous decision and new UC MMA middleweight champion, Carlos the Terminator Vemola! And your runner-up, Denniston Sutherland.
A new king is crowned here at UC MMA 35. Silvio Simac is backstage with a new middleweight champion, Carlos Vemola.
Congratulations on your victory. Tell us about your fight.
Thanks, mate. It was a tough fight, but I knew that before the fight he's durable. I knew I'm better in every aspect, in the stand-up, in the ground game, in the takedowns. I just knew. Great thing about Denniston is the way he starts, he finish. He's not getting any weaker at all. You know what I mean? I'm starting in the first round great, and I'm slowing down. But I'm working on it, especially for this fight. I didn't work on it. I did it very well. I was working great all the way through.
Okay, sure. Now, if I ask you a question, do you think traditional martial arts values of discipline and courtesy and honor are very important part of MMA?
It's all about discipline. Discipline is the word what I would look for in martial arts.
And mutual respect?
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah. Well, it depends who you're fighting. Sometimes there's no respect, and yeah, depends. I had a lot of respect for my opponent today, for a fact as well, because when I was training for the fight with Chris Lieben, he was helping me out with getting ready, because Chris Lieben is tough and durable, same as Denniston, and he did help me out. I never thought back then I'm going to be fighting him. Now, it wasn't a disrespect, it was... I don't want to choose my opponents now, just choose the opponents I can win. If I want to get somewhere where I was, I have to beat everyone out there, and he's a champion, so I have to beat him. But I want to fight the champions. That way I can prove I'm the best. I'm not picking my opponents. I want to fight the number one of every single federation in England. So yeah, it is about respect as well.
Sure, great. Thank you very much.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, it's main event time. We've got Marc Navarro fighting out of Scotland taking on Iain Badman Martell in a UK-1 light heavyweight title fight. Let's meet the fighters.
Hi, my name is Marc Navarro. I'm fighting at the Sky Axe Fight Team, Dundee. I'm 5'11". I've had 6 fights, 5 wins and 4 TKOs.
Iain Martell, I'm 23 years old and I fight at Team Carbon Liverpool.
I've been training hard for this fight like we do for every fight. I've been doing a lot of runs, a lot of hull sprints, a lot of hard sparring. Subjects and a lot of one-on-one pad work.
Training's been as hard as ever, and tonight I'm going to show you how it's done.
Iain Martell, I've been watching a lot of your fights on YouTube. I keep hearing you saying that you like a stand-up fight, so tonight we're going to find out.
Mark, keep your hands up tonight, my man, otherwise it's going to be a short, short night.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is for the UC MMA UK-1 Light Heavyweight Championship. Introducing your first fighter, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a UK-1 fighter with a record of 5 wins, 1 loss. He stands 5'11" tall. He weighed in at 88.4 kilograms. Fighting out of the Sky Axe Fight Team in Dundee, make some noise for Marc the freaking Rico Navarro! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a UK-1 fighter with a record of 9 wins, 1 loss. He stands 6 feet tall. He weighed in 93 kilograms. Fighting out of Team Calmon, here is Iain Badman Martell.
Here we go, guys. 3 threes. K1 rules. Any questions for me? Protect yourselves at all time. Listen to my words of command at all time. No elbow strikes. If I say break, break clean. Do not hit on the break. If there's a knockdown, go to a neutral side of the cage and I'll pick up the count. If I tell you to stop at any time, you stop. Touch gloves. Get ready for war.
No touching, unusual. Flying double knee by Martell. Immediately you can tell the intensity difference. Body shots by Navarro. Oh, this has got good fight written all over it. UC MMA 35, in association with Global Proving Ground. This is the kind of scrap you want to see, folks. Good short right uppercut there, yeah. By Navarro.
And what I like about this is there's a lot of body shots which you don't necessarily see. But with an MMA glove, that body shot is just so much more painful.
It's a good strategy, especially in the first round for Navarro. So he's going to take that explosivity away from Martell in the second and third round. But those knees are going to take his brain away if he's not careful.
He's penetrating with those uppercuts beautifully through the middle.
Here, Martell in the black shorts from the red corner. Marc Navarro, white shorts in blue corner.
You see Martell, more of a boxer. Hasn't thrown many kicks or any kicks.
Quite a lot of knees, though. A lot of knees.
Not Martell, sorry, Navarro. Navarro's not throwing any kicks.
Oh, heavy,
definitely
heavy
shots. Uppercuts. You know, I've broken my thumbs, both thumbs, with uppercuts to the elbows.
Heavy kick there by Martell. He's so explosive.
He's taking a lot of punches.
He caught him there with the left counter. I was going to say that inside fight style, that's the kind of fight that Navarro wants in this battle. He doesn't want to be trading distance with Martell. The ability he has to cover range is amazing.
And so far, Martell's knees are causing most of the damage to Navarro. He's cut.
He leaps into him so dynamically, it's perfect. They're causing some real damage. Another one. That's such a massive weapon in this UK1 rule set. Navarro is cut just under the right eye there. He's still in this fight though. As I mentioned, he's a tough, tough, tough guy.
Throwing some beautiful uppercuts in the middle.
You can hear him growl as he's throwing them. Martell's face also looking a little bumped up now. Navarro just walking him down. I'm curious as to whether Navarro may have hurt him at some point.
Yeah, no.
Oh, we may see a standing eight here. Referee for the count. For those of you who've been with us all night, obviously this is UK1, so you have standing eight counts now. It's not an immediate stoppage like in mixed martial arts. Martell must smell the finish now. Create some space, be dynamic, open up with a jab or a kick.
But as you said, Navarro is a tough character, and even though he had the eight count, he is the one moving forward, dishing the punches.
Setting the pace of this fight. He's not new to being hurt, to being in a difficult situation in the fight. Oh! Navarro looks very worse for wear.
The damage
we've got a standing eight count at the end of the round.
Martell. So
this
may
not be over.
I would have to give that to Navarro. He's the one with the cuts. He's the one with the blood all over his face. What an exciting fight. But he landed more strikes.
But then Martell had two knockdowns within that round.
So yeah, how do you score that? Is that a 9-9 round?
I believe technically speaking, you give that 10-8. Okay, good folks. Round number two. Lovely body shots by Martell. Why is he engaging him in this range? He does so much better when he's on the outside.
No idea. I would be kicking.
I would definitely be kicking, especially the shorter fighter. I'd be throwing those thigh kicks, up kicks.
Slowing down is going to be a stationary target. Navarro is still in this fight. Heavy, heavy body shot there, digging right into the strong frame of Martell.
Martell just catching his breath, and then he explodes. Here we go.
You can see the blood just in the back of Martell's back there from Navarro's face.
Big up kick there from Martell.
Is that straight up through the middle to his face? Referee breaks him. Oh!
Big knee. I think both of them should get an 8 count for that.
Grant was all over that. He knew it was a slip.
Oh, I think he kicked so high, if he landed on his head, he might have stunned himself with that fall.
He went for that jumping right knee. It seems to be his best weapon in this fight so far. More of those body shots from Navarro.
Oh.
He's set up for another knee as well. Martell's explosiveness has come down slightly. In that second round now, Navarro is starting to work him down.
One of those fights is just amazing to see how much these guys can take. The body punches, the head punches, the knees to the man's head.
The limits of the human body always astound me. And just the toughness of some of these guys.
That's definitely been a very exciting fight so far.
Navarro is... I'd actually give him this round so far. Martell has had a few flying knees, which have been incredibly impressive and caused a lot of damage. But Navarro is the one coming forward. Okay, this was the undoing of Navarro in the previous round. Dig in with those body shots.
I'd love to see Navarro just throw one knee. One knee would be great.
I'm curious, do you think Navarro is setting him up for those, like a short right hook or something with all those body shots? He's going to go down. He's trying
to make the man drop his elbows a bit so he can get the headshots in. So far, Martell's guard has just been superb.
He's going to be a bit slower coming into that round three, though.
I don't want to be a judge.
It's okay, you're a fighter.
I'm sitting here with you.
I am a very pretty man. Vocally, of course. Folks, thanks for joining us here tonight. UC MMA number 35, Global Proving Ground. Round number three, Marc Navarro versus Iain Martell. A little showboating there by Martell. Navarro is just unrelenting, man. What the hell do they feed these guys up in Scotland that makes them like this? It's just straight up tough. That right hook found its home there.
He's going to have some sore elbows, that Martell.
A bit lighter on his feet now, finally throwing some kicks. He's in no range.
At last!
Nice.
It's a K1 fight, you know? It's your bread and butter, those kicks.
I would like to see Navarro throwing some kicks from this range. I found as a shorter guy, you can actually get some power from this range with a short, small tie kick. Nice. Nice uppercuts there. And you can see the sweat fly off their bodies when he hits him.
He does need to move a little bit laterally. Marc Navarro, he's just leaning forward and punching. He should come from the side. You can see Iain Martell's guard's pretty good. He just needs to move sideways slightly to get deeper into those body shots.
Martell coming alive now.
Yeah.
Seems like he's just decided he wants to be back in this fight. Martell is now cut as well, bleeding from the nose. Navarro looks like a bloody mess. But he's still the one doing the work. I don't want to say he's carrying the fight, but he's carrying the aggression in this fight. I would like to see more of that from Martell. He looks very impressive, deep to the face. Flying knee.
He's been throwing a few of them and he just doesn't get that penetration. So he's slightly off target. He must be hurting. I don't think that those body punches are not hurting him. It will affect your movement.
They have slowed him down considerably. I'm curious as to whether Martell has in previous fights gone all out in the first round and then found that he's blown himself out. So maybe he's tried to stagger his pace a lot more in this.
He has been pacing himself throughout the round. You can see that he sort of covers up, and then he will explode for a second or two and then do it again. Whereas Navarro has just kept going, relentlessly kept going. Unfortunately, he's been kneed a couple of times too many in the face.
Yeah. Puts his chin down, his hands up, steps into range, body shots, uppercuts. And we go to another decision.
And both these guys are very happy raising their hands, and so they should. Asking the commentator the question, did I win?
We are obviously the authority in this.
And I've got to be biased.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of UK1 action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout 27-28. Judge number two, 27-28. And judge number three, 27-29. For your winner and new UC MMA UK1 light heavyweight champion, Iain Batman Martell. And let's have a round of applause for Tough as Nails, Marc Navarro.
Wow, three rounds of pure action, and what a contender you had to fight against as well. How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm happy to have a good fight in front of you guys. Throughout my career, I haven't really been happy with my performances, so thank you. I'd like to thank my coach, Colin Heron, Paul Sass, Mark Scangle, Mr. Team Chesty, and Nick Chapman. What are you doing in December? I've got a couple more fights at light heavy, and I'm going for middle. So Nick Chapman, come get it, baby. Let's do this.
He's left the building, otherwise I'm sure Dave would have him up there. How was your training out in Brazil? I mean, we've seen you come from strength to strength. You've gone away, you've fought, you've trained. How's that been?
Hey, Brazil was a mad thing, and I'd like to thank all the guys in Brazil, my coach Colin, and you know, the great experience. It taught me a lot about life, because all us in here are lucky, you know. We all got money, we all got a good system. Them back there, they ain't got. But let's be grateful for what we got.
100%. Well done. Everyone, your winner for tonight, Iain Batman Martell.
What an amazing night of fight, folks. You've been here with us at UC MMA 35 in association with Global Proving Ground. Neil, it's been fantastic here at the Troxy.
You know, it's been an amazing night of fights, some great decisions, some great finishes, and an all-round victory for MMA.
For myself, Simon Norman, Mr. Neil Grove, the Power Up Production crew, and UC MMA in association with Global Proving Ground, we thank you for joining us, folks.